This is another case study in Jaimini astrology using the chart of Angelina Jolie. Today I'm going to look at the Atma Karaka and the other Charakarakas, as well as the Dasha system called the Charadasha. So we have here the chart of Angelina Jolie, and I'm going to continue looking at her chart using the Jaimini indicators, which in this case I'm going to be looking at the Charakarakas, or the changeable, movable indicators that are used in Jaimini astrology. Now, these Karakas are different than the regular, what are called Sthirakarakas, or fixed Karakas, that we usually look at. For example, the natural, what's called Atma Karaka, is the sun. That's the fixed or Sthira Atma Karaka. Sthira means fixed, Chara means movable. So the typical Atma Karaka is the sun. The sun is the soul for everyone. That's the common Atma Karaka that everyone shares. So you should understand this. When you see Atma Karaka, it's not just the Jaimini planet with the highest degree. The sun is the natural Atma Karaka in what you might call Parashari astrology. I don't really like to use those kind of terms, but it's an effective way to delineate if you want. So the sun is the natural Atma Karaka, the fixed Atma Karaka, the Sthira Karaka for the soul or the Atman. But in the Jaimini system, the Atma Karaka, or the soul indicator, is the planet that has the highest degree. Again, this is totally based on sidereal zodiac, which is also the fixed zodiac, and always used as the fixed sidereal zodiac. And the planet that has the highest degree in any sign is the Atma Karaka. And in Angelina Jolie's chart, this would be Mercury. As you see, Mercury is 28 degrees 48 seconds in its sign. Then there are other Karakas. One is called the Amacha Karaka, which is said to be the minister or the thing we listen to. This is actually related to the moon. Just like we listen to our heart and we follow our heart, we follow the Amacha Karaka in another way to our sort of intuition, so to speak. I'm not going to go through every Karaka here. I'm going to talk about a few things, though, as it relates to it. Well, actually, let me just go through them. The Bhratru Karaka, it has to do with brothers, which is typically related to Mars. Then you have the Matru Karaka, which is related to the fourth house, and it has to do with the indicator of the mother. Now, these things are very specific in Jaimini astrology, where we can use these movable Karakas to actually look at people in our life, for example. So Atma Karaka and Amacha Karaka, which have to do with the sun and the moon kind of energy as well, are more kind of individualized. But then when we get into Bhratru Karaka, it has to do with like our siblings. Matru Karaka has to do with our mother. Pitru Karaka has to do with the father. Now, if you're using eight Karakas, then you have the Pitru Karaka as well. Then you also have a Putra Karaka, which has to do with children. And then you have a Nati Karaka, which has to do with relatives. And then the Dara Karaka, the seventh one, has to do with relationship partners. Now, there's a way to either use seven or eight Karakas based on whether or not you have planets in the same degree. This is the way it's been delineated and interpreted by some. I've looked at it this way. And usually what happens is when you have any planet that has the exact same degree, like for instance in Angelina Jolie's chart, you have the moon at 19 and the sun at 19 in its sign, then you would have eight Karakas rather than seven. If you don't have planets at the same degree, then you would only have seven Karakas. She also has Saturn at 23 and Jupiter at 23. So this would indicate that you would use eight Jaimini Charakarakas for Angelina Jolie. This is one way to interpret it. That's the way I choose to look at it now. This has pretty much comported well with my experience. When you're only using seven Karakas, then you have to use the Matru Karaka, which is the fourth one, and the fifth one, the Putra Karaka, or the child Karaka, as the same one. So you basically read the mother and the child from the same place, which I don't generally like because it just seems more inexact to me. It seems quite non-specific. So I tend to use eight karakas, if for no other reason, because I like that delineation. It's not just that I like it, but based on the research that I've done, it makes more sense. So we're going to look at some of that here in this video. Now, besides those Jaimini karakas, one way to use the Jaimini karakas is to take what's called the Karakamsha, or the Atmakaraka sign in the Navamsha chart, and read the Rashi chart from that sign. So, for example, we see her Navamsha here, and her Atmakaraka is Mercury. When you find Mercury in the chart of her Navamsha, you see that it's Virgo. So then you would read her Rashi chart from that position and look at a deeper kind of sort of soul nature based on reading the chart from that as being basically sort of the ascendant. Now, again, that's a simplified way to describe how to use these techniques, because in Jaimini Sutras, in Jaimini's Upadesha Sutras, there are actually very specific directives that you use when reading the karakas as well. But frankly, I've also saw some very good results when you keep in mind what we're reading in just using the Parashara type methods and reading the Rashi chart from the Karakamsha. So for example, when you do that, you see, like if you were to read her chart, you don't read it as if she's a Virgo ascendant. Like, you don't bring the psychology of Virgo and all that. It's very house specific because it's very much based on the predictions. So just like in the previous videos where we talked about Bhavapadas, this is, you know, this Jaimini system really has a lot to do with bhavas. And the main reason is because bhavas have a lot to do with our karma. They're very specific. And so when you're applying Jaimini methodologies, the more you understand bhavas and being able to read things from the place of bhavas and yogas and, you know, like Raja yogas based on bhavas and all that stuff, then you'll see the predictive power of Jaimini really come through. Most people are very weak in understanding bhavas, what they actually mean, how to find yogas, and then actually there are specific kinds of Jaimini yogas, especially that also have to do with Rashi aspects and different things. Again, I'm not going to get into that in this video, but the point being, you know, many people are very weak when it comes to understanding the specifics of Vedic astrology, especially as it relates to bhavas and yogas and all that stuff. They read things psychologically, because then they would say, oh, well, if you're reading the chart from the Karakamsha, then that means she's a Virgo. So, and then they bring all this stuff about Virgo details and all that stuff. It's not what it means, really. It means that you read the chart relative to yogas and karmas from that being the first house. And then the other planets are where they are. So for example, you would see that Venus is now in the 11th house, which shows literally like the 11th house is the public and large groups of people and the way we're seen in culture. She's got Venus there. Like, she's famous and she's known culturally as this beautiful person. Makes a lot of sense. You also see Saturn in the 10th house from that Karakamsha. Again, 10th houses are duties, responsibilities. This really shows a certain, you know, quality of why she works so hard, why she has, you know, at least why she was very driven and feels the pressure to be successful and to make an impact, which is a 10th house. When you read even the Rashi chart from the Karakamsha, you see that. Ketu, Sun, Mercury in the 9th house. 9th house about teaching, higher purpose, making a difference. You see that very clearly, right? Jupiter, Moon, Mars in the 7th. A lot of hope, inspiration, purpose, children, all these things tied up in relationships and partners. You can see that. And Rahu in the 3rd house. 3rd house, of course, has to do with siblings. She has a very unusual relationship with her sibling. Her sibling himself is quite unusual. She had a famous incident. I think it was like 1999 or 2000 or 2001 or something, where she literally like made out with her brother, like French kissing in public and stuff. So again, it's very Rahu, strange kind of thing with siblings. that's just a quick sort of way that you would look at it. But there's also yogas you would bring in. Again, you see, if you're reading this from Virgo, then this Sun Mercury, you know, this Mercury in the ninth is a powerful Raja Yoga in the ninth house. And it actually reaffirms the same similar kind of Raja Yogas in our ninth house here in the natal chart. And again, this is also something that you look for, a confluence between the, you know, the Jaimini, you know, Charakaraka or the Karakamsha and the natural chart, you know, the Parashara system and the, you know, and the house rulerships and the house occupation. In both systems, she has the ruler in the ninth. Because if we're reading the Rashi chart from the Karakamsha, then you see Mercury is in the ninth. If we're reading it from the regular ascendant, we see that the moon is in the ninth, and etc. So this is one of the things that you do. Of course, you would also read the Navamsha chart itself from this Atmakaraka for soul merit and spiritual merit and things like that. And you could even look at the nature of the spouse and things like that from also reading the Atmakaraka in the harmonic chart. And so forth and so on. So there are many specific methods for using these karakas, these charakarakas, or these movable karakas. One method as well is to take, for instance, the, you know, one thing that I've done before. This is, by the way, very good when you don't have birth times, for being specific. It's something that I do when I don't have birth times and I don't want to rectify, is reading from these charakarakas and reading the natal chart from the Karakamsha, and also reading other, and by the way, you can do this with good birth times as well, obviously, but even reading things like the mother from the Matru Karaka in the correct harmonic chart. So let's say the Bratru Karaka, which is the brother Karaka, reading like the Drekana or the third house harmonic chart from that place as being the ascendant. So you see that her Bratru Karaka or her brother or sibling Karaka is Saturn. So if we go there and we read the Drekana from that as if that's her in relationship to her siblings, then we would see Jupiter Rahu in the 10th. So there's a sort of public quality to it. It's quite unusual because we have Jupiter Rahu in the 10th. The ruler is actually Saturn. And we see, Saturn is actually in the it's not just in the ascendant, but it's in its own sign. So it shows a strong bond with the sibling and a strong kind of connection that she has with them. But there's also, especially three planets in the sixth house with the debilitated Mars. Perhaps his relationship to his masculinity is kind of weak. There's also a lot of moon Venus energy, which is feminine, sort of nurturing, maybe looking after him and wanting to maybe not be his mother, but sort of being quite protective of the sibling and his difficulties and struggles because of his planets in the sixth house. So again, this is how this person would see the sibling. And of course, it's going to show a quality of the sibling's life as well. Sun goes into the eighth house, the seventh house ruler in the eighth. Would show that she sees their relationships as something that's intense and dynamic and whatnot. This is a general kind of overview of a way to do that. And again, of course, we can also read the spouse and the relationship of the spouse from the Dharakaraka. Now, in her case, the ascendant and the Dharakaraka are actually in the ascendant of the D9, so it doesn't really change the way you would read the D9 in this case. But often when you'll have the Dharakaraka in another house, then you can get a deeper insight and even sort of like, I don't like to say things like a soul awareness because that's sort of cheap. Again, one of the things to understand about these Jaimini Karakas is they have a lot to do with the predictive quality and seeing what happens like in doshas and whatnot.